Hello there, everybody. Welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew Tunstall. I am going to explain to you very simply why it is that you struggle to lose weight. Now, most of us have issues with weight, and as we get older, it gets worse, and we try everything. We eat less, we count our calories, we get exercise, and somehow, for some reason, the weight is stubborn as, and it won't come off. In 80 or 90% of cases, the solution is very simple, or the answer, the explanation is very simple. So, your body can use two sources of energy, okay? It has two basic food sources from which it can manufacture the energy that you need to, well, to live, to build, to repair, for your metabolism to work. Those two energy sources are sugar, which comes from, well, sugar, or from starches or carbohydrates, which are actually just sugar molecules all rolled up in big clumps and given different names. It's all sugar. Or fat. Those are the two things that your body can burn. Now, when you are overweight, you have a lot of excess body fat, which is a potential fuel source. So you would think that if you eat less and you get some exercise, you will burn off that body fat. But it doesn't work. Why not? You can eat less and less and less, count your calories, even be hungry, and somehow you can't burn off the body fat. Well, here's the explanation. When your body has a choice of sugar in the blood and fat in the blood, it will use the sugar first. And the reason is that in order to carry sugar around and take sugar molecules to your cells, like your muscle cells, your sugar needs an escort. So your body produces insulin. Your insulin level goes up, the insulin in your blood grabs onto the sugar molecules, takes them to the cells that need the energy, and those cells detect the insulin and open the gates to allow the sugar in, which they then burn for energy. Okay, so that sounds all very simple and efficient, and I guess it is, normally. But when your insulin levels are up because you have been eating carbohydrates or sugar, that stops your fat burning process. You cannot burn fat if your insulin level is elevated because you have been eating carbohydrates. So if you have a mixture of carbohydrates and fat in your diet, you will not burn any of that fat, and you will not burn any of your body fat. You won't lose the weight. It's impossible to lose the weight when you keep eating carbohydrates. Even if you don't eat a lot of carbohydrates, but you eat them regularly, three times a day, you have carbohydrates in your meals, maybe a snack, a soft drink in between, sugar, 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 you're never going to burn your body fat. Okay? It's quite simple. Now, it gets worse. This gets worse, and in most people's cases, in the case of most people who are overweight, this is now already what's happened. Your sugar intake is so high, pasta, potatoes, bread, more bread, soft drinks, sugared things, sugared dairy products, everything has sugar or carbohydrates or starch in it, that your insulin level is much higher than it would be naturally. And your cells are bombarded with messages from this delivery, from messenger, from insulin, banging on the door saying, more sugar, open up, I've got more sugar for you. And they become deaf to it. You become insulin resistant. And your cells go, I'm not sure that could possibly be insulin knocking on the door with more sugar. It doesn't sound likely. So your body says, well, then we have to produce more insulin so the insulin can shout louder and convince the cells to open up. So you get more insulin and more insulin and more insulin. So it gets more and more and more difficult to burn fat, and more difficult for the insulin to get the cells to accept the sugar. So you end up with some sugar that doesn't get used at all. And that spare sugar, your body has a plan for that spare sugar. It turns it into body fat to store for later. So that excess sugar gets turned into body fat, added to the body fat you already have, but you're hungry because the cells wouldn't take the sugar. So even though you're putting on weight, you're running back to the fridge to get more food. And invariably that food is carbohydrate based, because that's the world we live in now. And you eat more carbohydrates and you just make the problem worse, and you don't lose any weight. You can go running if you like, and you will only burn sugar. You will not burn fat, because you can't, because your insulin levels are high, because you eat carbohydrates. Eventually, the worst part of it is, when you are insulin resistant and you become obese and you continue with this down this downward spiral, you end up with your body just giving up altogether and saying, I'm not going to make insulin anymore because it's a waste of my time. And your body shuts down the production of insulin. That can kill you if you don't then inject yourself with insulin every day for the rest of your life. That's when you're diabetic. So it becomes fully fledged diabetes. So insulin resistance has another name. It's pre-diabetes. If you are obese, you are pre-diabetic, almost invariably, unless you have a very unusual medical problem, which is of course possible. But in most cases, we get overweight just because we eat wrong. We eat too much sugar and we don't realize we're eating it. We might cut the sugar. Don't eat sweets, don't put sugar in your tea. But you're eating carbohydrates, you're eating pizzas and pasta and bread and fruit juices and fruit, everything with sugar in it. It's too much. That's why you can't lose weight. You can run as much as you like, you're not going to lose weight. If you want to lose weight, stop eating carbohydrates. Let your body adapt from a sugar burner to a fat burner. And that can take a few days and feel a bit rough for a few days, especially if you're quite a little way down the pre-diabetic thing, because you're addicted to the sugar. So you need to get your body off the sugar, off the carbohydrates, onto the fat. It'll start burning efficiently. You won't be hungry anymore because, I mean, look at this big spare tire you've got around your tummy or your bum or your thighs, all that body fat that you are so keen to get rid of. It's a spare energy source. Now you can access it and you will burn it off. And then your hunger levels will naturally regulate your eating, and you will eat as much fat as you need according to how hungry you are. Just don't eat the carbohydrates. Then you will be able to lose weight. That's it. Simple.